This is Health and Medicine.
The Americans with Disabilities Act has been around since 1990, but its mandates have not been enforced everywhere, and that's led to a growing medically underserved population right here in the city. Our health reporter, Erin Billups, has details.
Visiting the doctor's office can be a nuisance for most, but for these ladies, getting accessible medical care has truly been a journey.
This woman in a white coat comes down the hall, her arms flailing around, waving, and looks at me and she says, "No, no, no, people like you can't come here." And I said, "Where should I go?" And she said, "Where people like you go."
Marilyn Saviola heads up Women's Advocacy for Independence Care Systems and says that's just the problem. There are very few places for wheelchair-bound women to get comprehensive gynecology services.
I couldn't even come in the room. I had to leave my chair outside the door. I went to another place. I could actually get in, but I couldn't get on the table.
The process was so frustrating for Manion Lyons that in the past, she would wait up to 5 years before attempting a trek to the doctor's office, a dangerously long time for a woman with disabilities.
We have a lot of incontinent issues. That requires DYN often because you need medicine for that, and you have skin breakdowns and rashes.
Now Lyons travels from Harlem to the Bronx to one of the few places that caters to her needs. Since 2011, HHC's Morrisania Diagnostic and Treatment Center has been working with ICS to make its facility more accessible.
Some of the changes we did was get exam tables that can move up and down and use some Hoyer lifts to actually lift patients.
The clinic also had to renovate its mammography room to make it more accessible. They repositioned the mammography machine, got maneuverable chairs, and also just made the room wider so that those in wheelchairs could get around a little easier.
It didn't cost us that much. It cost us maybe less than $20,000.
As a result, the city council allocated $5 million to HHC to build exam rooms for disabled women in all of its facilities. But New York Lawyers for Public Interest says it's not enough. Private hospitals need to step up too.
There have been laws on the books for over 20 years that mandate accessibility for people with disabilities, and it's just not happening. And we think it's because there's such a lack of awareness among providers.
Erin Billups, New York One.